Markus Vanhala, the guitar player of Finnish band called Insomnium.
Semmoinen bass player and vocalist of the same band.
Jani Liimataiden, nowadays guitar player of the same band.
Melancholic, like the music.
Yeah. We're generally excited. Happy with the album and a lot of good things happening, hopefully. We got a cool music video or two cool videos coming in.
Feeling kind of like after sex, empty and sort of depressed.
Well.
There's one guy more doing the music.
It helps. He immediately got the Insomnium vibe. So when there's a song done by him, it still sounds like Insomnium. I don't think people can spot the composer by just listening to the song.
I mean, this is my first album, so I don't know how they worked before. It didn't change for me.
Yeah, it's nice to have like a tour de force at the moment, like four guys doing the music, so it makes things easier. There's no too much pressure for any certain guy. Everyone is competing with each other with the music.
Not competing and completing.
Completing.
Of course, it helps a bit. We have one extra guy here who's doing a lot of work also, so
more is more.
More is more.
Like our Swedish guy said. Mainly on the album there's even more than three guitars. We might use even five guitarists on stage and we still couldn't replicate all the stuff on the album. Modern technology makes you gay.
Yeah. The difference is live playing where you actually have three players occasionally. In the studio you can do overdubs as much as you want, so.
And some of the early.
Yeah, it will be a special occasion as Ville will be every now and then on the gigs, yeah. And not on every gig, so we have to do two different kind of variations for the live sets. But it worked well in Johnsmith Festival last summer, we tested it out. There's enough to play for everyone. Enough and more.
I guess the beginning of the process was easier, that everybody just started doing stuff and making demos, and you didn't need this grand plan in the beginning.
We are pretty bad on planning.
Yeah, we just
stuff
do
and
stuff.
Life. We just do. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not so good. With the album it came out good. We did it in few shows and we decided to cut the song for certain parts. At least I don't like it. It's 40 minutes. Miss.
All or nothing. Yeah, that's how it's supposed to be. We had some like support shows where our set time was only like 40 minutes and we were supposed to promote the new album still and play something from Winter Skate. So that's when we decided just to play some parts, but it feels a bit wrong to do it like that.
Be stupid like watch Arnold Schwarzenegger movies and just fast forward to the ending fight.
Yeah,
same with just game.
Well, new stuff, of course.
Yeah.
There were some older songs that we took back in the set this summer that worked really nicely, some faster, Into the Woods and Against the Stream.
They were fun to play.
Yeah. the feeling that we are going to play those in the next cycle.
Well, we did this summer this one special show in Finland. We played the whole Across the Dark album through, and we had to rehearse some new songs because of that. Because there was some songs we never played before live. At least we haven't. So, apparently, there might be something we need to set up. Of course, we've been waiting the whole summer to play these new songs for the people because it's so new stuff.
Yeah, it was kind of weird during the summer festival since the album was ready. But you can't play the new songs, so they're kind of sitting. That would be good stuff to play, but we can't do it yet.
Seems to be very good.
No one threw anything on stage.
Yeah. People seem to enjoy it. We played it. No one threw up.
Sad metal.
New genre.
It's not really far from what we've done before, of course, but one day in Dallas, USA last year, we just started talking about this. So I don't know where the idea came originally.
Let's dive deeper to the Finnish melancholy, way beyond the suicide song or the cliches, to the old school stuff.
Which is even like more dark in a way, I think. Or at least those little parts that you mentioned in the press release. Like,
dark medieval times of Finland, which happened 100 years ago. I think we discovered something really old.
Well,
it's like every song is in the tradition of some old Finnish sorrowful classics of the 50s, whatever, 60s.
Yeah, or even older stuff.
Yeah.
So, well, I think there's a bit of sentence vibe on the album, also in the lyrics. Obviously, I think Sentence has been using the same kind of references in their lyrics before. But we kind of skipped the suicide thing on this album. It has a different vibe. You just wait and hide away in your misery and it lasts long.
Everything sucks and you don't even die.
Yeah, that's so the mood of the album. Don't even die.
Songs of sadness and persistence. That's the Finnish way. Everything sucks, but it's sweet.
Is that also kind of like the Finnish mentality in general? Like kind for of. The international audience watching this.
Yes.
Yeah. Death metal version of Tapio Rautavaara.
Of course, seriously.
Everyone knows Tapio Rautavaara.
If you don't,
badass. The most saddest song of Finland all time.
Yes.
Peltoniemen Hintriikan suomarssi, Tapio Rautavaara. So you know Finland is the land of sorrow and misery. And that's the most sad song. So I guess that tells the story.
Was it your goal to have an even sadder song than his?
But actually, on our album there is an adaptation of that song. It's called At Bell State Hall. That's the adaptation of that song. We tried to make a version that the international community could understand, maybe.
Yeah. It's not a direct translation, it just dwells on the same themes.
Yeah, inspired by that.
I tried to listen a lot of these Finnish songs and read a bit of poems, even I don't know the lyrics, but just get the inspiration from the music. And get the feeling all times. Misery.
Doesn't it like bring you down to like research on that stuff? I mean, I don't know.
No.
Sadness makes us happy. We like to see people suffer.
That's why we make music.
Misery is our kryptonite.
Well, that's kind of the scenery of our soul, is the Karelian landscape, the forests and the lakes. And when we had this instrumental, well, at least for me, automatically, the kind of images I get in my mind is that kind of landscape. So naming it Karelia felt like a very natural thing to do. A lot of things on this album are kind of intervening together. There's a Finnish theme interconnected in each of the videos at Koli. And that's why we wanted to have this
listening
promo days last week there also. Some journalists could see the place also.
Sentenced wife on the album, as Niilo said, and Vesa Ranta, former drummer of Sentenced, made the both music videos for the album. So, the domino kind of thing.
Yeah.
But many things have happened, like, maybe without a reason, basically. Like, we hit the surface. We didn't plan to have like Vesa in the first place doing the videos, and we didn't plan to do the only videos all in a natural way.
It felt good to do them like that.
Some magic and mayhem.
But it seems like the way you tell it though, it's kind of like some kind of a puzzle. Like, I mean, everything is interconnected, but everything was like kind of randomly planned, or?
The puzzle came together, but we didn't know what the pieces were when we started.
Yeah, exactly. But now when you look at it from this point, it all makes sense. Like we had the video and the photos and the lyrics and the song titles and everything, they were together.
It looks like a great marketing plan, but at first place it wasn't.
Yeah. We'll get lucky.
Well, I just saw
yesterday
the preview of the video yesterday, and it seemed very Vesa-like. You can really tell about the actors. It's directed by Vesa.
Works well.
Really Finnish.
So
that's what we were after.
You're talking about actors, so can we like expect the stories like being, you know?
Yes. Yeah, you can expect. Yeah.
Okay.
It's actually a story spanning two videos. They are interconnected.
So the first video kind of only introduces these people and these things, and in the second video it all makes more sense and you can see some kind of story.
Hopefully.
We
haven't seen that.
We haven't seen it yet, but we've been told that it makes sense in the end. But these two videos are meant to be together, like, everything go together again.
So yeah. The plan and theme of the video is making some sense.
Yeah. And like the story that you see, does it match like the story that the lyrics are about, or is it also something else?
No, it's a bit different thing.
Not the story, but the mood.
Yeah, the mood is the same. Fits very well this whole album and both songs, of course.
We sleep, we drink, we play.
Disappointment and disillusion.
Well, we're gonna play the new songs for sure. We can play the whole album if we wanted to, let's see. How many new songs we're gonna play, and some old classics, of course.
Something new, something old. Something borrowed, something blues.
Something black.
Well, there was a lot of stuff that was really funny or ambitious or really well made, so it was, I don't know how many entries in total. I think in Instagram we had something like 300, and didn't even check myself how many were on Facebook and Twitter. But so there were hundreds of entries into competition. Really great stuff there. But it wasn't easy thing to pick those or only two.
So how did you decide on the winners?
Well, the record label was even involved, and they picked first kind of first batch of candidates, and then we picked the two winners from that bunch.
And the winners were introduced for sauna with us.
Yes,
in Koli.
I hope you weren't traumatized.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So only they lose. Everyone else win.
Sorry.
No. I don't.